Having made a full recovery, Smith is now trying to adapt the culture she works in. She says of the city, "It's not known for its team spirit. It's still an alpha place to do business, but I don't think it has to be like that. You don't have to be a ball breaker, and I don't believe in all that macho stuff." Taken from an interview with the Standard newspaper, July 2011. She now says she's found a good balance, and this includes making herself do something every year that pushes her out of her comfort zone to try and progress herself and keep herself motivated. Jeff Kindler resigned from his position as chief executive of Pfizer in December 2010, stating he needed to recharge his batteries. He provided this statement to the press at the time. "The combination of meeting the requirements of our stakeholders around the world and the 24/7 nature of my responsibilities has made this period extremely demanding on me personally." In 2011, the chief executive of the UK property services group Connaught, Mark Tinknell, resigned shortly before the company collapsed. Connaught issued a statement saying Tinknell needed to recover from recent health issues. Masataka Shimizu, president of the Tokyo Electric Power Company, left in a controversial period for his company, citing a personal matter brought on by overwork and lack of sleep. Joseph Lombardi was the chief financial officer of the bookstore Barnes & Noble in the US until 2011, when he abruptly resigned. "I think he's exhausted and ready for a new challenge," said a colleague. Whilst it's difficult to find any concrete statements about the reason behind his departure, it seems the general assumption was that he was exhausted, having fought a very public battle with a major stakeholder and been at the helm of a company that was undergoing major industry changes. One thinks of Huffington's words about icebergs and Titanics and wonders if there was less stigma around stress and mental health, an improved culture of work-life balance, and less competitive presenteeism and machismo, then perhaps there would be more vigilance and fewer collisions. All about the dopamine. If money makes the world go round, then it's dopamine that draws it to the city. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter that helps to control the brain's reward and pleasure centres and is also a precursor of adrenaline. It's what drives a lot of us to repeat our behaviours, both good and bad. Dopamine is what we experience when we complete a large task. For example, I had a huge rush of dopamine every time I completed a section of this book and an enormous surge once it was ready for publishing,